Well, good morning, all of you. Chairperson of the panel, and I'm going to present my paper. I'm the son of the chemist and the classical and the astronomer, which is research. The effectiveness in application of general concept of mindfulness, that is BCM, and the Buddhist concept of mindfulness, BCM, in psychotherapeutic interventions. Practice of mindfulness. You know, mindfulness is an emerging field globally. Lot of practitioners use mindfulness techniques as their mode of treatment interventions. And mindfulness has advanced in research arena as an increasing trend in psychotherapeutic practice. Number of studies of therapeutic interventions have been conducted in the world. When you look at this graph, you can see over the years, the mindfulness journal publication over the years has been increased tremendously over the years. In 2017, nearly 700 articles have been published in journals. So it's a gradual increase. Mindfulness-based interventions have become very efficacious as a mode of treatment, and many attempts have been made to test how mindfulness can be effectively integrated in therapy. There are so many research have been conducted. Professor Kabat Singh in the USA and Professor Theo Noe in the Australia and Professor Mark Williams in the United Kingdom, they have done massive amounts of work in this field. This is Professor Kabat Singh, who has introduced the widely accepted definition for mindfulness. He says the paying attention, mindfulness is paying attention in a particular way, on purpose in the present moment and non-judgmentally. This is the most widely accepted definition for GCM, general concept of mindfulness. It is basically non-evaluative awareness to one's inner and outer mind. The concept of mindfulness has its roots in Buddhism. The Professor Kabat Singh has accepted this. Now he has boldly said that he has taken this idea from Buddhism. The teachings of the Lord Buddha is truly universal. It is not exclusively for Buddhists, but this can be applicable to everyone. The real Buddhist concepts. Attempts to integrate mindfulness into therapy. There are so many attempts have been made. They have done successful to a certain degree. However, they do not demonstrate the profoundity of mindfulness as in Buddhism. There is one missing part. I have narrowed down the real concept, and it may have hindered the full use of its potentiality. So a lot of people have pointed out, especially Professor Theo Noe and other people, they have clearly mentioned that there are some missing parts. There are differences between Buddhist and Western psychological conceptualization of mindfulness. When implementing it is important not to use the effectiveness in real mindfulness as in the philosophy. So what we can see is there are some missing aspects. So we can see in therapeutic intervention there are certain drawbacks there. So missing vital roots is the original concept of Buddhist philosophy in the process of meditation to psychotherapy. There are increasing number of questions regarding the real meaning of the methods used in contemporary practice as given in the original Buddhist context. So the aim of this research is to study the missing points in the contemporary practice of mindfulness and to investigate how counselors relate their true meaning of mindfulness as in contemporary Buddhist practice, and to explore its application in counseling interventions. So this is the methodology to conduct the qualitative research design. It's a phenomenological approach, and cognitive and small voice sampling methods were used, and 15 qualified counselors were tested, and of course they were interviewed. And open ended face-to-face interviews were done, and we then transcribed the data, and data analysis was done. And finally, we went to the instant Cambridge and Mrs. was conductor. So and after that, we went into the results and we have emulation also is done. The results were very interesting. These are things. The essence of the BCM is the Buddhist concept of mindfulness. The council emphasizes the right view, which is the cognitive change. And the right mindfulness is a Buddhist way. So normally in general practice we just barely say it's mindfulness. But when it comes to Buddhism, it is not mindfulness alone, it's right mindfulness. So relationship between right view and right mindfulness is another thing. And right view is a prerequisite to achieve right mindfulness. That is the initial step. So the effect when it comes to effectiveness, effectiveness in Buddhist concept of mindfulness has more consolidated therapeutic outcomes. You see, the right mindfulness is a key concept in the original Buddhist philosophy. It is not integrated so far into the Western world. And it is not discussed in the Western applications. So being mindful about the realistic nature, what is right mindfulness is, you have to be mindful about the realistic nature of the world, which is gained through right view. Without the right view, in this suttas, it is clearly mentioned, without the right view, you can't have the right mindfulness. So this key is the right view and the key concept in the original Buddhist philosophy. It is not discussed in the Western adaptation. Seeing the world in the right way and as it is, that is the realistic nature of the world. We have to see the true nature of existence. This is clearly mentioned in books, in the Buddhist text. This is Majjhimanikaya, the three and pages here. This true nature of existence, the true nature of the world is explained through reaction. So we have to go to all these deeper levels to understand this. But this can be discussed in a very simple manner also. So we live in a changing world. Changing is continuous and exponential. We know about that. And we interpret the things either positive or negative. The way how you look at things, that is the cognitive aspect of this. So changes don't happen according to our wish. If we can agree with the changes, we would like it. And if cannot, we would against them. That is where all the problems are arising. So the general concept of mindfulness is this, paying attention in a particular level of purpose in the present moment and non-judgmentally. This is the definition. When it comes right mindfulness begins with comprehension of the realistic nature of existence, which is the right view, and engage in mindfulness practice in the systematic process, that is where the Noble Eightfold Path, aiming at ultimate cessation of all suffering. So that's a long way to go. And when you consider the Noble Eightfold Path, so right, you can see it's the eight-step process, and the right view is the initial step. And the right mindfulness. So without having the right view, you can't have the right mindfulness. So that is the understanding. And the right mindfulness, as in the original Buddhist philosophy, is a bigger concept. This one of the participants. It is like the elephant's footprint. You can keep the footprints of all time creatures. Now this BCM is the total solution. BCM is sort of like not like just putting a plaster to a problem. It has a long way to go. There are so many areas to be covered. But simply we can address the issues as well. The right mindfulness, as in the original Buddhist philosophy, is a bigger concept. General mindfulness is only a small aspect of it. So Buddhist concept of mindfulness, BCM, promotes the realization of the true nature of existence besides the irreversible cognitive change. Once the cognitive change has been done, it is not reversible. It is irreversible. But general concept of mindfulness is reversible. Right? You have a lot of drawbacks. So relationship between right view and right mindfulness is the right view is the prerequisite to right view, right mindfulness. The participants has clearly said that. So we have this graph shows how the person is suffering since the person is having a wrong view. And when the initial discussion is having, the person is helped, the individual, the parent, is helped to understand the true nature of existence. And then the person, you can have a cognitive change. into the higher view. So once the person is attained the higher view, so the person may reduce the unsatisfactoriness, suffering and all sort of psychological problems. And there, from there onwards, you start really practice mindfulness from there onwards. Otherwise, that cannot be done. So the whole mindfulness counseling process is a total process. In the mindfulness counseling process, ultimately it will go. It's a long, long, long process ultimately. But if you can do it here, in counseling, that's a real change in life. So the conclusions, the main problem with the contemplative practice mindfulness based intervention is that it does not aim to achieve cognitive change. Right view is a prerequisite for right mindfulness. It is crucial to understand the original meaning in the Buddhist philosophy to have a right therapeutic intervention. BCM can be effectively implemented in psychotherapy. The need of universal model for mindfulness is we should have the consolidated model for mindfulness is not available. So the limitation was the research participants were from Sri Lanka following Theravada Buddhist tradition in which the original Buddhist philosophy was based on. Only the 15 samples, it is very hard to generalize the findings with this few number of people. And future research reactions would be check the applicability of this novel approach with participants from other Buddhist traditions. That's my suggestion, and who are non-Buddhist. And this can be done. So how the missing code is created in the integrating the BCM into contemplative practice of mindfulness. And my suggestion is to develop a mindfulness counseling model, covering everything. And these are my references. And my acknowledgement must thank my supervisors and the people who contributed to me in numerous ways.